Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Hello and welcome back to Daily December. This is video number 20. Oh, well it isn't, but it's the 20th of December, I miss a few days. And today I want to talk to you about my Disney trip. So this is going to be more of like a vlog, but I'm going to step in to explain things because I got a bit overexcited and yeah, some of it's not that coherent. I also don't know if you can see, but I'm wearing this super cute Mickey and Minnie top. So if you say that I'm not organised, you're wrong. And also this trip was back in the summer. I think it was in June or July. And I wasn't going to post it because the footage is so old, but I posted a poll on Instagram of whether it was too late or not, and like 92% or something of people said that they still wanted to see it, so blame them, not me. I also do have such a bad cold in this footage, and my skin looks awful, and I sound awful, and I look really grumpy, even though I know I wasn't deep down, but I had such a bad cold that I felt a bit crap. So without further ado, you are about to join me on my trip to Trattoria al Forno, which is an Italian restaurant in Disney World, which then turns into like a character breakfast at breakfast time with Eric. I've got my priorities straight. Ariel, Eric, Rapunzel and Flynn Rider.
We're hoping to have breakfast with Prince Eric and Flynn Rider, and I'm hoping to come away with a husband. I don't know which. Which one would you prefer?
Well, I really like Prince Eric, but I know you like Prince Eric too.
So we're gonna have to fight to the death then.
We are.
For sure, it's Ariel!
He's crying already. It's me. Look at these pastries! There's a little star and a clam, oh my god! This is incredible. Just watching Flynn ride from afar.
Thank you.
Thank you. And she seems to be a bit flustered. What was he doing, Hattie?
Stop it! He was smouldering.
He was smouldering.
That's what Flynn Rider does, doesn't he? He smoulders. Here comes the smoulder.
Do like a relaxed face, and then I'm gonna count down from three, and you have to go into your smoulder. 1, 2, 3.
So for context now, you can probably see in the footage, but Hattie took one look at the guy that was playing Flynn Rider and fell in love.
I made eye contact with Hattie and she's actually completely lost it.
Yeah,
we got a little crush.
No, he genuinely got attracted. I don't know what it is. He just looked at me and I fell. Apart, not for him.
I made her.
So happy. How did that go? Hattie was laughing at everything Flynn Rider said, and then he said something, he made a joke and had to spat a drink out of him.
So, what happened was, Flynn Rider was talking to Hattie and he said something very charming, I can't remember what it was, that whatever it was, it isn't relevant. And Hattie was so flustered and so taken off guard that she spat her drink out all over the table and over him. And he laughed so hard that he had to turn around in case he broke character because he couldn't stop laughing either. And it was honestly one of the highlights of my trip because it was so funny.
How do you feel now that you've met your favourite princess?
Princess! Very happy, she's so pretty.
How do you feel now that you've spat on her significant other?
Not great, I'll be reliving that for a few days.
So then it was time to meet Eric, who is the love of my life. He's always been like my favourite Disney prince. And he came over and he said something along the lines of,
we could go for a boat ride on the lake. It's beautiful. And that's not the only thing that's beautiful.
And then I like just could not stop giggling. Thing is, like, I don't fall for lines like that. It's not that. It was just that, I don't know, it was just a lot, you know? So after breakfast, we moved on to one of the parks.
We are now in Hollywood Studios, which is my favourite park. I love like the theme of it and how it all looks. And like the fact that it's all supposed to be like backstage kind of thing, I just really like it.
And while we were at Hollywood Studios, we'd told our waitress that morning that we were going there, and she said that we had to try the Frozen sing-along, which I wasn't going to do because I'd rather do the rides and the shows and stuff, and yeah, it just didn't really appeal. But she said that it was more of like a comedy thing than a kids thing. I mean, it's suitable for kids, but like, they make it fun for adults. So we went.
Our waitress this morning recommended that we try the Frozen sing-along. She said it's less of like a sing-along thing and much more of like a comedy thing. So we've come, it looks so good. I'm excited to see what this is like.
I don't know what you said, kid, but I agree. Elsa, yes, Elsa, very good, it's Frozen. She froze the entire thing in the process.
She froze all of Arendelle, sending her kingdom into a cold dark earth.
It was beyond cold. It was Frozen!
Men don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be.
Gone. The cold never bothered me anyway.
And you can't really see how funny it was in the clips that I took. I didn't want to film too much, but it was so funny and so good, and I think we'll definitely go there again. And then we went to, well, it used to be called One Man's Dream, but I think it's now called Walt Disney Presents. And that for some reason is always one of my favourite attractions. I really love looking at like the process of everything and all of the like artifacts they have that were Walt Disney's and stuff. I just think it's really interesting.
So this is Walt Disney's original like drawing desk, and it says that he drew Snow White and Seven Dwarfs and things from here, which is really, really cool. These are like, this is like a prototype model thing of the new Toy Story Land, which is opening 2 days after we leave, which is the most annoying thing in the whole world.
And then lastly, we went and watched Fantasmic, which is the Hollywood Studios fireworks show. I'd never actually seen it before, but it was one of the best fireworks shows I've ever seen.
For we now invite you to join me and experience Fantasmic. A journey beyond your wildest imagination.
Actually, a lot of it wasn't even fireworks. A lot of it was projections on water, and a load of it was really based around the villains, and I love the villains. And at one point there was this, they were projecting like villains onto the water in front of you, and then the water dropped, and then there was just this gigantic like luminous snake.
That's ridiculous. That's so cool.
Impressive on the footage than it was in real life, but it was so cool. And then Mickey comes and he fights the snake and he fights the villains, and then one of the Maleficent turned into a dragon, and the dragon was there, and that was really cool. and there was like fire and water and like magic. It was so good. And yeah, so that was the end of that day at Disney. I miss it so much. So it's a good thing I've got another trip booked for next year. I'm obsessed. There is one more Disney vlog to come. I will link the first one on the end card of this video because there was one more before this of like our first and second days. And there's one more to come after this as well, which I'll either post tomorrow or the next day, we'll see. So yeah, I hope you're enjoying the Disney videos. Let me know in the comments what your favourite thing to do at Disney is, if you've ever been, and if you haven't, do you want to go? What looks the coolest? Or where is your favourite place to go? Just chat with me, I just like chatting. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I will see you tomorrow for more Daily December.
Oh, the fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. As long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.